Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Tanaya and this is Ouyon Beauty. In this video, we're finally going to do my makeup collection and makeup storage. Some of you guys were asking me for it, and I'm sorry that it took me so long to get to it. I've just been so busy since my kids started back to school, just trying to get on a regular schedule of things. I just haven't had time to do it. But today, I finally have time, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to do that. Now, I do not have like my own separate beauty room. Right now, I am filming either in my bedroom or in the little hallway space that I have set up. So I don't have like a huge makeup collection. I don't want to have more than what I actually have room for, but I think I have a pretty good amount. I think you guys enjoy it, and I just want to kind of show you guys how I store my stuff in a smaller space. Alright, so this is my whole vanity area, so you can kind of get a full span of what everything looks like. Let's go ahead and just kind of show you each section and what I have stored there. So this is how I store some of my palettes. I got these shelves off of Amazon. I was trying to find a way to get storage out of my drawers so that I can put some more stuff in there. When I first started doing makeup and really getting into makeup, this little drawer sat right here. This was all I had. I had just this one, and it sat over here in this corner. This wall over here originally was where I had my cosplay closet, the one that's currently in the hallway. You guys have seen that one. Luckily, we had the space in the hallway that I was able to move that out of there, and then I had room to make this my little vanity area. Like I said, these came from Amazon. They were advertised as storage shelves, display shelves for children's books. I like these because, as you can see, I can store palettes sideways, so I can put a pretty decent amount in each one of these shelves. The top here, this is where I have like most of my bigger palettes. I have my Tiny Marvels palette. I absolutely love that one. I think this entire section over here is Revolution. I have all of my Nomad palettes here, some BH Cosmetics palettes on this side. The goal is that this entire shelf is gonna be ColourPop. Right now it's about 90% ColourPop. I do have a few palettes over here that are not, but pretty much this entire shelf is ColourPop. I love my Bring Me Coffee and Tell Me I'm Pretty sign right here. Isn't that what we all want, ladies? Just very simple. Bring us coffee, tell us we're pretty. That's all we want. This is where I keep all of my skincare that I'm currently using, and yes, it is a lot. This organizer came from Wayfair. I have my Gerard Cosmetics X Rich Luxe. This was a collaboration that they did, the Bust of the House Ice Cream Shack. It was the setting spray collection. There were two full sizes and one travel, which I absolutely love. Over here is where I have a lot of my body products. In here is pretty much where I keep all of my blemish stuff, so like tea tree oil and stuff like that that I use whenever my skin is like breaking out or anything like that. I have moisturizers, exfoliators. I'm really enjoying this toner right here, which is the pharmacy one. I have my Mulan makeup bag. Right here is where I keep all of my makeup sponges. I really like this mesh basket because when I wash my sponges that are slightly damp, I can put them in here and I know they're not gonna get moldy or anything because of the mesh. It just kind of airs them out and they dry faster that way. In this drawer is where I keep some of my Shop Miss A skincare pouches, the ones that don't really kind of fit up here. So I keep them in here. I have some eye cream in here. It's an eyebrow razor. I also keep my makeup wipes in here. I guess we'll talk about what's up here first and then we can get into the two drawer sets. This vanity I also got at Wayfair. When I decided that I wanted to start my makeup channel, of course I needed somewhere to film. I needed a background, so I picked this up from Wayfair. It was like $169. It was not very expensive at all. I wanted one that had a light up vanity mirror. Those were very expensive, so I actually found these lights on Amazon. Anything that I got that I can still find, Amazon, Wayfair, whatever, I will try to link those down in the description box below in case you guys do want to try to get those. But these were $20. They just stick to any mirror, and they have this little switch over here that you use to turn them on and off. It just plugs them underneath the vanity. Turns any vanity mirror into a light up beauty mirror. I absolutely love them. I have my makeup brushes here. You guys have seen these when I did my makeup brush collection declutter. I keep my dirty brushes back there. I have my Zen Garden. I got this from Five Below. It was packed away for the longest time because I didn't have anywhere to put it, but I was finally able to reorganize the vanity, and I just think it looks really, really cute up here. This is my Tony Moly Eye Cream. This is my Oriental Vetiver Cologne or Perfume from Dossier. I think this is a Jo Malone sample. I love this candle. This is the Taylor Wynn Love You Loads. This was a collaboration with Anchorage Northwest Candle Company. I think it is. It literally smells like fresh laundry, like you just did your laundry. It smells so good. I've almost used it up. Unfortunately, this was a limited edition candle, so I'm not going to be able to get it again. But they do have other candle scents, so I'll probably try them out. This is my Tony Moly. This is an oil control serum. It's empty, but I just absolutely think this packaging is so adorable, so I keep it on my vanity. I just think it looks so cute there. This is my little light-up vanity mirror. Regular magnification on this side, on the other side. I think this is like 10 times magnification. I use this side a lot, you know, being over the age of 40 and basically blind. I got two more brush organizers here. This one I got from Amazon. This one I got from Michaels. These basically I use to just separate out my eye brushes. Makes it so much easier. They used to all be in little cups. This makes it so much easier to see what I have. And of course, my beautiful babies. Love them. This is my Juno & Company Moonshine Miracle Cream. I don't use this very often. Just looks really, really cute on the vanity. My A+ brush cleaner up here. This is a Gerard's Cosmetics Lippy. I don't really use this. I just think the packaging is really pretty. The lipstick, hold on, let me show you real quick. So you just take it and you push the top and it pops out the bottom. This one has those really pretty glitters all over it. But yeah, the shade is not one that I would ever actually use. So it just sits on the vanity looking all cute and pretty. Keep setting spray here. This cup right here is where I put my dirty makeup sponges. I have some more face sponges here. This little lipstick set, this is basically what I'm turning into my bullet lipsticks because I'm slowly starting to get more into bullet lipsticks. I have some Shop Miss A1s here. These are from AOA Studios. I'm not sure where this one is. So all three of these were in my last Shop Miss A haul. This one is from Uden's Eye. This one is a K-Beauty product. All of these were from the Sophia Nagard collaboration with ColourPop. I think I'm saying her name correctly. I apologize if I'm not. These three are from the Hocus Pocus. These three were from that Mulan collaboration. I absolutely love Mulan. These will probably never really get used. I've used this one, but I have not used the bullet lipstick and I haven't used the gloss. They're basically just collectibles. This one is also K-Beauty. I used to keep a bunch of liquid lipsticks and glosses in here, but I have since moved a bunch of them up here. I got this from Shop Miss A. This, I showed you guys how I did this in my last blog. This was supposed to be for like skincare pouches, the ones you get from Shop Miss A. I got it for face masks, sheet masks. As you can see here, they're not gonna fit in there. So I turned it into a little holder for lippies, basically lip glosses and liquid lipsticks that are in these like long skinnier tubes. I want to get another one of these. This has made it so much easier to see what I have as far as the lippies are concerned. By having them in here like this, I can instantly see the colors and the shades so I can grab for something. I don't have to like keep pulling them out, you know, like keep doing this to try to see what everything is. Eventually I want to get another one and I'm going to take all of these and move that into that little area in that little organizer. Got my trash can here. This little basket right here, this is where I keep everything that I'm going to use for future giveaways or friend mail. I keep my little extra tabletop ring light right here. This is for when I'm vlogging and stuff and I need a little bit of extra light. I also have this picture here. This used to hang above my vanity, but as you can see, I kind of move some things around. Think about putting that in the hallway filming space in the background. Let me know what you guys think about that. Right now, it's just kind of sitting under the table because I don't really know what I want to do with it. This is my little AOA Studios mixing tray. I absolutely love this. This was like $1.88 or something. Basically, you can use this for like mixing foundations. If they're too light, you can mix a couple shades together. I've been using it to mix like lighter or darker concealers in with lighter or darker foundations to get a better skin match, mainly for the ones that I'm trying to like work through in my Project Empties, Project Panties, that kind of thing. Let's do the first drawer in the vanity. This right here is just where I keep my planner. I keep all my planning stickers in here, my to-do list, my pens. I have a clipboard in here. In this drawer is where I keep all of my eyelashes, which I just started getting into like last year. Before last year, I wasn't really into eyelashes, but I love them now. This is where I keep those. Eyelash curler, all kinds of like tools and stuff in here. I have an eyebrow razor. Tape for when I want to do like these really sharp lines on the outside. All of these are lip products. There's some lip balms in here. I have my e.l.f. lipstick remover. I love my two little art pieces up here. Both of these came from Five Below. I am my own muse. And this one right here, I thought looked like lipstick swatches. That's the reason why I got the one. I just thought it looked very, very abstract. Over here is where I have all my like genre collectible palette. This one is from Supernatural. I have some Disney ones here, Mulan, Tiana, Hello Kitty. I love this little ramen noodle one. That is so cute. This is a face milk that came from that ColourPop Milan collection. This palette is from Moana. The palette absolutely sucks, but as far as the formula, but I love the artwork on the front. This was the PR box that the ColourPop Milan collection came in. Milan is my favorite Disney princess, so you know I got it. I just think this is so beautiful. This will be in my background forever. I have a Sailor Moon palette. This is the Milan palette that came in here. The box for the Tiny Marvels palette is back there. I keep some of the boxes from some of the collections and stuff that I really like. These sunglasses were a gift from my daughter. Tiana palette, Powerpuff Girls. This is a lip mask from that Milan collection. This is where I keep all of my setting sprays, all of my face mists. I keep them in this little basket here. This is like, I guess my tabletop lipstick holder here. Most of these in here are just like are liquid lipsticks, matte lipsticks. I have a couple of bullet lipsticks up here. Both of these are from the Trixie Mattel collection. This is Flower Beauty. None of these will fit in these little holes here or in the other one, so I just kind of keep them on top. I do have all of my Jeffree Star liquid lipsticks, at least the ones that I kept, because I really do like these shades. I have not been able to dupe them yet. That's why they're still here. Once I use them all up, though, I won't be repurchasing them. As you can see, I still have a whole lot of storage here, mainly because I moved all my bullet lipsticks into there. This is where I have all of my foundations that are in like bottles and stuff like that. These are the foundations that are in tubes. I also have my CC and BB creams in here. This is that e.l.f. matte cream foundation. OG, but a goodie. I absolutely love that. This is the Aquasurance foundation, the pressed powder foundation. Visible Touch face powder from Kiko Milano. This is from Benai. This is their cream foundations. I use this for cosplaying, for costuming, if I want to cover up scars, stuff like that. That's what I use that for. This is my project panning basket. This is everything that I'm currently either trying to empty or to pan, and I'm actually doing a pretty decent job. Since I did that first project panning video where I showed you guys the products that I was trying to work through, I've actually worked through some of those and added some new things in here. I will show you guys in a later date how I'm doing with that. This right here is basically my face makeup drawer, little storage area here. This is all of my loose setting powders. Over here are pressed powders, and I also have bronzers and stuff like that in here. Concealers are over here, color correctors are here. Over here are all of my primers. If you guys would like to see more intensive collections as far as my face products, let me know. I would love to do that for you guys. Face glitters. These are those shadow sticks from ColourPop. Not my absolute favorite formula, but you know, I keep those in here. And here is where I keep all of my eyeshadow primers, my eyeshadow bases, glitter glue, stuff like that. It's in here. And these are where I keep my ColourPop lippy sticks. Once I get another one of these little organizers right here, I'm going to move all of these into another one of those. All right, so let's move into this first set of drawers here. Like I said, when I first started getting into makeup, this was the first thing I had to start my makeup in. Everything was in here. Eyeshadow palettes, blushes, highlighters, face powders, everything was in here. They look like they're Alex drawers from IKEA, but they're actually not. I got these from Amazon. Like I said, if I can find them, if I still find them available, I will go ahead and link it, but you can find these and other brands too, but they work really well. You know, they keep everything together. This first drawer, this is where I keep all of my liners and stuff. I have my brow pencils here. Mascaras are in here. These are all of my like ink eyeliners. So like black eyeliners, white eyeliners, but these are all ink liners. These are all my color gel liners. And as you can see, I have a lot. And then these are all of my lip pencils. The second and the third drawers, these two are highlighters. So this is where I keep all of my pressed highlighters. This is ColourPop. Have a mixture in here. Yeah, Kiko Milano. It's pretty much all this is right here. It's a Jaclyn Hill one. These are all my Kimchi Cosmetics ones. These two are from Becca. That one's from Elf. These are from that independent brand, the one that unfortunately does not exist anymore. What do I have here? I have some Shop Miss A. I have one from The Bomb. This one's from Essence. This is a newer one. Not my favorite formula. It's very glittery. This is also from Essence. This is the Pure Nude Highlighter. I heard so many good things about this one, which is why I got it. But on my skin, I don't know. I felt like it didn't work very well for me. These two are Malibu Glitz. These are actually listed as foundations, pressed powder foundations. No way do you want to put these all over your face. They are so glittery, but they work perfectly as highlighters. These two are from Milani. Some Hard Candy. This was a friend mail gift. This one is the newest one to my collection. That's from Beauty Bay. All of these back here are creams or liquid gel highlighters, stuff like that. I have some more pressed highlighters over here. These are the bigger highlighters that don't fit like sideways. All of these are from Revolution Beauty. These two are my only loose highlighters. I just don't believe in having a whole bunch of these. You're never going to pan them. You don't tend to use these as much as you do the other ones. This is that really cute one from Revolution Beauty. It's a tasty peach. Just looks like a giant peach. I love this one. And it smells like peaches too. These last two drawers are blushes. So I have all my pressed blushes in here. These are like ones that have like more than one in them. So basically face palettes, but I keep them in here because they're just all blushes. There's nothing else in them. I have my Kiko Milano ones back here. I have Essence, Flower Beauty, Winky Luxe, Juvia's Place, this is a BH Cosmetics, Amuse, CoverGirl, Elf, these are Malibu Glitz, Lumi. I have a lot of them from Shop Miss A because the formulas are really good. They're only a dollar for most of them and they're really, really good. This is from JCat Beauty, this is from Milani. Said OG Luminoso shade. That Kimchi Cosmetics one, which I absolutely love. Both of these are, no, this is Milani. That is Amuse. Actually, I'm gonna move these in here. Move this over there. This is one of the new ones in my collection. It came in my No Make No Life box. I think you're gonna see that unboxing right after this video. But this is the blush that came in. That's from Tony Moly. Has a cute little bear on it. It's so stinking adorable. AOA Studio Powder Blushes. Both of these are gorgeous formulas. All of these are ColourPop. All of these are ColourPop. I probably have more blushes from ColourPop than I do anything else because they tend to come like in collections. But I seem to have more ColourPop than I do any other blush formulas in here. Both of these are creams, stick blushes, liquid blushes. I really like this one from Kiko Milano. All of these are those ColourPop blush sticks. This is one of my favorite new formulas to my collection. This is that Milani cream blush. I like this one better than the e.l.f. blushes. I just think that it goes on so much smoother. And then I have some space to grow. This basket right here is where I put all the makeup for my like weekly, bi-weekly rotation. I'm actually about to put this away and pull out something else. The Stone Cold palette, which I absolutely love. I currently have that in here. The e.l.f. Chipotle palette. I also have my OG Urban Decay Born to Run. This one I'm probably gonna end up decluttering later on. In this palette, this shade right here is literally the only one that works for my skin tone. The other ones don't show up at all. It doesn't make much sense to like keep a whole palette for one shade. I have a bunch of lippies in here. Mainly the CoverGirl ones, the full spectrum ones, which I'm currently working through. Also threw one of those cheek dews in here. I wanted to try that formula out some more. And this set of drawers, this is where I keep my face palettes. I have some more eyeshadow palettes in here, other makeup tools, stuff like that. This top drawer, this is all face palettes. So we have blush palettes, highlighter palettes, bronzing palettes. I love this one. This is from Lunar Beauty. It's the Moon Prism Blush Palette. This palette is absolutely stunning. It is one of my favorite palettes in my entire collection. The shades look like they're going to be like really light and not work on a deeper skin tone, but they work like on all skin tones. They are so beautiful. Every single shade in this palette works on me. I have smaller face palettes here. In the second drawer, we have mostly all of my mini eyeshadow palettes. I have collected so many mini eyeshadow palettes this year. I have a bunch from Kiko Milano. I have a whole bunch of those little ColourPop ones. This one, it's not really a mini palette, but I keep it in here because it is kind of small and it fits in here. It's the Aquamarine March palette, the Birthstone palette from Beach Cosmetics. I only grab this one because I'm a March baby. My Uden's Eye palette right here. I absolutely love this formula. I need to put this in my makeup rotation so I can get some use out of it. These are those WandaVision palettes. Most likely these are going to be decluttered later. These are the newest ones to my collection. These are those Essence palettes. I have, what is this? It's a Sugar Pill palette. These two are from LA Colors. This is a Weva palette. Perfusion. What else? Is that it? Well, that's everything in here. I have more palettes in this drawer. Some Juvia's Place palettes. Some more Urban Decay. I have my little Tarte Juicy palette in here. I absolutely love this one. This is one of my favorite everyday palettes. Juvia's Place. This one I got from Hot Topic. I'm actually going to be taking this out soon and putting it up on my display shelves for Halloween. I have a few more palettes in here. This one is that kombucha palette. I absolutely love this one. This has become one of my favorite ones in my entire collection. Juvia's Place palettes here. There's one from The Balm. This one is one of my favorites in my collection. This one is that Butte Bean X Shroud It's Freaking Bats palette. The color story on this one, you guys, it is beautiful. It is stunning. Betty Jean did such a good job with this palette. I think it's currently in stock. If you go to the Charlotte Cosmetics website, and I don't think it's currently sold out right now at the moment. But this palette is absolutely stunning. Black Widow. These are those Milani Salt and Pep palettes. This right here is a set of makeup brushes that one of my best friends gave me. She sent these to me for my birthday. They came from Amazon. And basically, they are a set of Avengers themed makeup brushes. There's like one for each one of the Avengers. You have the Infinity Stones here and this one. I don't use this collection very often for obvious reasons. I like to keep it in the bag, you know, for collecting purposes. The quality on these brushes are really, really good though. This is where I keep my eyeshadow swatches. This one is from BH Cosmetics. This one came from the Dollar Tree. It's actually pretty good quality considering it came from the Dollar Tree. And this last drawer, this is where I keep cotton balls. I have all of my cotton ovals. These I just got from Shop Misset. They're little cotton squares. I keep towels in here that I use for cleaning my makeup brushes. All of my hand mirrors. I have my AOA Studio mirror, which I absolutely love. Both of these are from ColourPop. This one is the cherry one. This one I'm probably going to end up throwing out. I'm very sad. This one came with that Valentine's Day collection, but I'm about to show you. As you can see, the mirror came all kinds of scratched up. It literally looks like a cat clawed it before they put it into the box. It's very, very disappointed in that. More than likely, this is going to end up being tossed later. I like to keep them in their foam. Original foam packaging so they don't get scratched up. These two are my little kind of hand LED mirrors. This one lights up, if you can tell. I haven't really been using it though because I've been needing more magnification, so I've been using this one I got from Five Below, which is I think it's like 10 times magnification. That one works really well for me when I'm filming and needing a little bit more of a close-up when I'm doing my makeup. This is my little micro needler. I like to use this in the days that I do my deep exfoliation. So that's it for like this main area. I have my ring light over here. That's my little table that I film with. Over here is where I keep all of my backup makeup, skincare, products like that. I used to have a little small shelf and I realized I needed something more. Eventually, when we get ready to move, because we are looking at moving next year, depending on the space, I probably will get another one of these so that I can expand and have more storage. This was only like $30 at Target. Up here is where I keep extra storage baskets. I have some filming stuff in here, filming light bulbs, some microphone right there. This is where I keep all of my Nida headbands. You know how much I love those. This basket is where I keep all of my super soft little headbands, like basically the animal ears and stuff are in here. This is where I keep barrettes. I have all of my hair ties and scrunchies. Keep all my hair clips in this one. This row is basically my filming row. And what I do is whenever I want to film a makeup video, whether it's a get ready with me, trying new makeup, whatever, I put everything into a basket and put it on this row. And it makes it so much easier for me to film because then I can just pull the basket. And it also makes it easy to type up my description boxes because everything is in here. This basket right here is the stuff I just used today to film my look that I did for Instagram and TikTok from the Beauty Bay palette. That was the look that you saw at the very beginning of the video. Nail polish remover is here. This is beauty tools, cotton balls, sponges, etc. Well, the cotton balls I keep it somewhere else now. But I have sharpeners in here, extra little magnifying mirrors, brush soap, oil absorbing sheets, this little hair dye brush. This is where I keep my backup foundation, primers, concealers, setting powders. I bought two backups of the Becca Under Eye Corrector. I absolutely love it. It's my favorite corrector of life. And as you guys know, Becca will be going out of business next month. So I make sure that I grab two backups, at least have a little bit to last a while. I have a Milani powder in here, this flower setting powder. This is the translucent powder that came out of a Boxytron box. I have not used this one yet. I just finished using the cassava powder. Love the formula. This one is liners, mascaras, extra brows, brow products, and lip pencils. That's what I keep in here. This is hair care stuff, shampoo, hair treatments. I have an extra shower cap in here as well. Sheet masks are here. This is all of my nail polish and nail tools. I have some more sheet masks here. These are basically the boxes and stuff that don't fit in the other ones. Hand sanitizer spray, mud masks, peel off masks. All of this is body care products. So there's lotion, foot care products, foot peeling masks, hand lotions. These are those Soul Body foundations. I go ahead and I keep those in here. And I have another one. There's Ben Nye foundations. Like I said, this is what I use for a scar cover, stuff like that, whenever I'm doing cosplaying and costuming, which I have not done any of this year. This one is where I keep all of my facial cleansers, face toners, makeup wipes. So all facial cleansers in here, scrubs. I love this mask right here. This is a turmeric mask. There's just some toners from Shop Miss A. I have makeup wipes back there. And basically, I kind of have everything in order, so I know what I want to grab next to use and try out. This one right here is where I keep all of my facial treatments. So there's moisturizers, face serums, eye creams, all of that is in here. And then this basket is my Jeffree Star palettes. Now, I am no longer a Jeffree Star stan. I do not support him. I do not purchase from him anymore. The last thing that I purchased from him was this little cremated palette. I have not purchased anything since, but I did spend my money on this. This was not cheap, so I still use them. I just don't use them in videos. So that was my full makeup storage and collection. Like I said, if you guys want to see any more extensive collection videos, mainly like, you know, the face products, foundations, primers, concealers, stuff like that, let me know down in the comments below. I'll definitely do that. As far as like highlighters, blushes, eyeshadow palettes, stuff like that, I will be doing another collection video or another set of declutter and collection videos later on in the year. I did obtain a lot more eyeshadow palettes after I did my collection video in the summer, so you'll be seeing those later on in the year. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, be sure to give it a thumbs up because it really does help my channel. If you're not already subscribed, I would love it if you would consider subscribing and joining my little family. Don't forget to tap the notification bell down below to get notifications of any videos coming up in the future, and also be sure to follow me on TikTok and Instagram. Be safe, take care of yourself, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.